Good afternoon. Thank you for listening to me today. So I'm going to be talking about my company, Cohesity, and the title is, Are You on a Titanic? I'll explain that in a minute. So a little bit about my company first. The company was founded in 2013, and I'm the founder and CEO. Before founding this company, I was the founder and CTO of Nutanix, where I pioneered the idea of hyperconvergence. And sometime in past life, I helped build the Google file system. So that's kind of my background. This particular company, it's headquartered in Santa Clara. And we have a very strong set of people here, very proud to have a team from some of the prime companies in the Silicon Valley, including Google, VMware, Riverbed, Nutanix, and NetApp. We recently announced that we raised a total of $70 million in venture funding from top-tier VCs in the Valley, including Sequoia, Excel, Artis, Battery Ventures, and Excel, and so on and so forth. So what are we doing? Let's talk about that next. So we liken the storage in a data center to an iceberg. The tip of the iceberg, the part above the surface of water, is what we call primary storage. That's where you run your mission-critical apps. But the part below the surface of water, that's what's called secondary storage. That's where you run your non-mission-critical apps. That's what we are trying to disrupt. That's what Cohesity is trying to do. So that begs the question, why does it need disruption? What's missing in it? So to understand that, let's talk about what constitutes secondary storage. Sometimes people think that secondary storage is only backups, but actually it consists of file shares, archiving, test and dev environments, analytics, data protection, cloud spills, all that stuff is secondary storage. So upfront, you can see a problem that it's very fragmented. In fact, you have to go buy all these products from different vendors. So there's a huge data sprawl. So the problem is, trying to change the slide here. So all this data is dark data. It's kind of like you're sitting on a Titanic. You don't get any insights from this data. We did a survey of IT professionals, and it turned out that not only are people spending a lot on secondary storage, there is a huge data sprawl. There are lots and lots of copies floating around the data center, and they have no insights into what's stored there. So so what about security? What about compliance? It's kind of like you're on a Titanic waiting to hit that iceberg, and all you can see is your primary storage. What about the secondary storage? That's what's going to hit you. That's what we're about. So what we do, our vision, is to take all those workflows in secondary storage, all those file shares, archiving, data protection, and so on and so forth, and converge them on one infinitely scalable storage platform. It's Google-like scalability. It's web-scale scalability. So we are into secondary storage consolidation. That's what we try to do. That's what we are about. Okay. And let me talk about where the company is. So we've been kind of doing early trials since about April, and we have cumulatively consolidated across all our customers about 5 petabytes of data so far, and it's actually growing pretty fast. So in the next couple of months, the customers that have lined up, we expect to kind of quickly ramp up and consolidate nearly 80 to 100 petabytes of storage. So that's what we are. And visit us in the booth downstairs. And we are all about bringing data to your bringing order to your data chaos. Thank you.
Terrific. All right. Why don't we start with Suzanne?
Sure. This sounds like a great value proposition, and the idea of reducing cost and economizing the storage is a very straightforward value proposition. So what are the objections that you're seeing out there within the folks that you're talking to and the companies that you're approaching with this idea?
So sometimes people look at this and they're like, oh, wow, this has been a pain point for ages. And aren't you sometimes, you know, aren't you trying to do too much? And we're like, no, when you simplify stuff, when you bring it together on one platform, you can actually incrementally grow that platform and actually slowly grow into the data center. So that's one of the objections that, hey, are you trying to do too much here? And the answer is no, we are actually trying to simplify your life and thereby incrementally grow. So there.
John?
I'm just trying to get a handle on how you're relating to cloud, which seems to be you're going back to a data center focus, and yet an awful lot of this information that you've got in that underwater is now being taken to the cloud. So how does your system relate to that?
Excellent question. So it is true that a lot of stuff is going to the cloud, but I say that the cloud is kind of like renting a hotel, and your private data center is kind of owning a house. And you understand the trade-offs, right? One gives you great experience, one gives you maybe cheap cost. We are actually about both. So there is no one way or the other way. I think we want to bring the best of both to people. So when I say I want to consolidate secondary storage, it also includes the cloud. And I believe I said cloud spills there, for example.
Yeah, let me focus a little more, though. Not just the cloud, but specific vendors in the cloud. GitHub, Dropbox, Box for file sharing.
Right.
So when you're saying that you're doing the cloud, you're talking about integrating with those services or essentially a hybrid cloud environment?
So I'm talking about spilling, let's say, your data protection stuff, your backups, to the cloud, and helping you do that using a single pane of glass, as opposed to having one product that deals with the cloud and a second product that deals with just the backups in your local storage. And maybe having your test and dev environments, some running in the cloud, some running locally, all through different UIs. I'm talking about consolidating all that. So I'm talking about your secondary storage, right? Your Dropbox and stuff. Dropbox is a very consumerish stuff. I'm not talking about that. GitHub is probably used for some of your mission critical check-ins and whatnot. So we might integrate with that in the future. But upfront, we are integrating with test and dev environments. We are integrating with data protection environments. And we are providing insights. We're bringing all that dark data to light by integrating analytics into this environment.
Can you talk a little bit about what's happened on the technology front that's allowing you to treat sort of the deep storage more like primary storage?
Right. So one of the things that has happened is our DNA is into building huge distributed systems. And some of that innovation has hit the primary storage space. There are companies like my last company, Nutanix, that brought infinite scalability into primary storage space. And now we are trying to bring the same innovation to the secondary storage space. How do you consolidate everything when you cannot even scale, right? If you cannot scale, then you are forced to run stuff in silos. And when you run stuff in silos, then you get tired of the manageability, and then you start moving stuff into the cloud, and then you get even more tired about the manageability because you're managing some stuff in the cloud, some local. So the fact that our DNA is in kind of building these infinitely scalable platforms, and the other part that we bring now to the table is to be able to converge stuff, run multiple workloads simultaneously. That's the innovation we bring to the table now, and that's what's allowing us to converge all this.
Okay, terrific. Well, please, CIOs in the room, check out their demo in the pavilion, and it will be available throughout the day. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.